For any two non-empty set A and B, every subset of A cross B is called a binary relation from set A to set B. In order to find maximum how many relations we can define from set A to set B, we are going to follow this procedure on the right-hand side of this page. And we'll illustrate this procedure with help of an example. Let A is a set with two elements A and B. And there is another set B which has only two elements, 1 and 2. If we want to find out maximum how many relations we can define from set A to set B, we are going to do these steps. Step 1, what we are going to do is we will find out number of elements in A cross B, which is denoted by A cross B, and then place bar on both sides. This is called cardinality of A cross B set. So this will be equal to cardinality of A, means number of elements in A, times number of elements in B. So number of elements in A, as you know, are 2, and there are 2 elements in set B, so that will be equal to 2 as well. So the total number of elements in A cross B would be equal to 4. So step 2, for step 2, number of relations of binary relations from set A to set B, from A to B, would be equal to 2 power n. If n is 4 here, so this will be equal to 2 power 4. So this is 2 power 4 is 16. So this many relations we can define from set A to set B. Let's find out and verify actually how many relations we can find out. So here A was equal to, so verification, we will find out actually relations, and for that purpose we are given A is equal to AB and B is given equal to 1, 2. So let's find out actual relations. And every subset of A cross B is called a relation. So first we are going to find out what is A cross B. A cross B is equal to A1, A2, B1, and B2. So this is Cartesian product of sets A and B. Now every subset of this is called a binary relation. So let's find out which one are. R1 is first relation, and since empty set or null set is subset of every set, therefore R1 is taken as empty set. R2, all the singleton sets. Singleton sets mean subsets of A cross B which have only one element as their member. So we will write A1, that is one relation. R2, and this is R3, this will be A2, and this will be second. R4, this is B1, and R5, this will be equal to B2. So all the singleton sets are done. And now we are going to find out the double sets, means the subsets of A cross B which have two elements in them. So R6, will be equal to A1 and A2 R7 will be equal to A1 and B1 R8 is equal to A1 and then B2. And now we will start with the next element, R9. That will be A2, B1, A2, and then B1, R10 is equal to A2 and B2. And now R11 is equal to B1, B2, B1, B2. So these are all those subsets of A cross B which have two elements in those sets. And now we will find out those which have three elements. So how many were there? There were 11, and now R12. R12 would be equal to A1, A2, B1, and R13 would be equal to A1, A2, A1, A2, and B2. R14 and this time it would be A1, B1, A1, B1, and B2. B2 and the last 15, R15 would be equal to A2, A1, B1, A2, B1, and B2. So these are all those subsets of A cross B which have three elements in them. And now every set is a subset of itself. So R16 would be equal to A1, A2, B1, and B2. Now this verifies that according to the formula, we were able to calculate maximum 16 subsets of A cross B, means that there could be maximum 16 relations from set A to set B, and we have found those relations in fact here. And this is the way to find out maximum number of boundary relations from set A to set B. If you were to follow the same procedure for finding number of relations from A to A, it will be simply the same procedure.